There are 7 text functions in Excel that are extremely important for text manipulation, and we'll quickly go through each one so you can see an example of when and why they would be used. So the first one, we'll go over left and right. Left will return the characters in the beginning of a string, and right will return the ones at the end. So for the date, we can bring back the date by just using the left function here. Then you'll choose the text cell that you want to return the characters from, and then the amount of characters. So this date's 10, so we will type in 10 characters, copy that down. It won't work for the bottom two because it just returns the beginning 10 characters. If we want to return the 10 characters at the end, just type in right. So now that it's right instead of left, that will work to bring back the date in these two cells. So similar to left and right, we have text before and text after. So for the description, I'll show you how to use text after in this case, text before for the next ones. So text after, you'll choose the cell you want the text to be manipulated from, and delimiter will be a space. So to represent a space, you'll do a double quote, space, and another double quote in a function. And then the instance number, this will be the first instance of it since there's one space before we return the rest of what we want. Then in parentheses, sales order and refunds. So now we can use text before to return something before a delimiter. So we can choose this cell and also do a space. In sales order, since there's a space between sales and order, we'll choose the second instance. But if we copy that down, we're going to need to change this to the first instance since there's only one space before. So that's how you use text after to return something after, and text before to return the text before a delimiter. Delimiter could also be comma, is pretty common. In this case, it's forward slash. You could also do a period, dollar sign, and various other delimiters that will work. So similar to what we just did, there's also a function called TEXTSPLIT, which in this case would not be as useful, but if you type TEXTSPLIT, this is great for names and other scenarios where you need to split a cell based on its delimiter, just kind of how we did text after text before. You can just split the whole cell. So the text, we can just choose any cell. The delimiter will also be a space. That's all you need to put, and it will split the text from one column into 3 columns to make a row. You can also copy that down to show how this has multiple spaces, so it takes up an extra column, where this only has one space, so that's where the delimiter splits it into 2 columns. And this can be very useful. And you can also move these around or hide certain cells. So that's text split, which is useful. Now we have concat and join. So concat's used a lot for combining different columns in a row to then later be uploaded into an application on a website or a certain report that Excel just doesn't really paste well into in multiple columns. So we could do sales order. And you can also add spaces or your own text here. So put commas in between them. Then we could put status is complete as our own text. And then you can concatenate however long you want. Add as much stuff. Also add the amount here. And so now if we copy this down, you will see that it concatenates into one column. We can actually even add an extra space into here. Just to add an extra space at the end. This is great for just copying and pasting since it's all in one cell. Similar to concat will be text join. This is easier if you're just going straight across a whole row and want to combine everything. So the value for text join will be the delimiter, which is also a space in this case. Ignore empty. So say the customer ID is empty here. Do we want to include or ignore? So we can ignore. And then for text one, you can just combine this whole entire row. And if you go through, it combined every single value in this row into one cell. And there are 7 useful text manipulation functions in Excel. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. Remember to like and subscribe. And thanks for watching.